Hello everyone, this is Mar Haddad here again. In this lecture, I'm going to show you how the MikroTik hotspot works. So I'm not going to go into a lot of technical things on configuring the MikroTik hotspot because this is something going to happen in the upcoming lecture. But what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to show you what happens in the background when you as a user get connected to the MikroTik hotspot. So what will happen and then how you'll be able to get access to the internet. Okay, so this is what I'm going to show in this lecture. So as you can see here, we have a router from MikroTik and this is configured at the hotspot and it is connected to the internet. So for example, if we say that this router here is providing the wireless connectivity, okay, and he has internet connectivity, then we have a user here. Let's say this is my computer now, which is also on wireless, and he wants also to get connected to the internet. Then what happened is that this hotspot here, he will be propagating an SSID, which is the name of the wireless, okay? And he will say, for example, the SSID is, for example, hotspot, okay? So you, on your computer, you can intercept this SSID and you can get connect to it. So what happened here, when you connect to the SSID, which is here the hotspot, you will get connected directly because there is no password for you to put on the wireless. That's what I said in the previous lecture. It is a wireless public network. That means it is open for everyone and everyone can get connected to it. But that doesn't mean here that you are getting connected to the internet. So in the background, what happens? When someone like this computer here is connected to the wireless, then the hotspot, MikroTik, will provide this computer an IP address. Okay, so we provide him an IP address with a subnet mask with the gateway. So in this case, there is a DHCP server which is sitting on this router providing all those information to the users who are connected to this MikroTik hotspot. Okay, so this is very important to remember that one, you will get an IP address, okay? So you get an IP address from the MikroTik router. And then what happens that if you go to your computer here and you open a browser, for example, you write www.facebook.com. You are connected to the wireless, that's true, but doesn't mean that you will directly go to this page. What happened that when you try to open anything on the browser, you will be redirected to something we call it a captive portal. Captive portal is a page which is inside the package of the hotspot on MikroTik, and it will ask you to enter a username and a password. And this captive portal is coming from the MikroTik router to your computer here. So it's an HTML file, and it asks you to put your username and password. So that means that you are connected to the wireless, but you're not yet connected to the internet because you need to be authenticated. So the second point I can say here that you need to have authentication. Okay, so without the authentication, you cannot get connected to the internet. And the authentication happens on the MikroTik router here. You will have a place where you can create the accounts that you want to create, okay? So you can, for example, put in an account and you name it, for example, test as username and password 123456. And then in case this user here put the username test and the password 123456, then he will be able to get authenticated. And then in this case, he will be able to bypass the firewall that it is already on the hotspot MikroTik router when you create the hotspot and to be able to be connected to the internet. Okay, so now also when you create the MikroTik hotspot, then what happens, there is a NAT here configured. So a network address translation, or what we call it in MikroTik masquerade. Okay, the NAT is configured to allow the IP addresses that we have received from the DHCP server on the MikroTik router to be NATed on this router in order to be able to reach the internet. So there is a NAT which is going to be configured on the MikroTik router in order to allow us to be able to go to the internet. So these are the main things that happens in the background when you are trying to connect to the hotspot wireless to be able to go to the internet. Now what I have done, I have created on this router a hotspot. So on my computer where I have a wireless, so this is the computer where I have wireless on it, So I'm going to try to connect to this hotspot, and I will see if I'm able to get connected, and we will see if we get this captive portal and all the information that we have just learned. So let's do this experiment now. So here I am on my computer. So I would like now to connect to the MyCritic hotspot that I have just created. To do that, I just need now to take out my picture here so you can see what's happening. So I will go from here to the wireless, and you can see here that is the hotspot that I have created. So I will click on it, and then I will say connect. So now I'm connecting to the hotspot, and as you can see, I'm already connected, and I'm directly redirected to the page which is asking me to enter the username and the password. Okay, let me just close this one, and I will show you here that I'm already connected to the hotspot, but I don't have internet. You can see it's no internet open, but I'm connected to the hotspot. Okay, now here, if I want to go to the command prompt and I say ipconfig, you can see that we have received an IP address on the wireless LAN, which is 172.18.1.254, and that's the from the DHCP server of the hotspot. He has already given us an IP address, but also with the gateway and the subnet mask. But we don't have access to the internet at this moment. So if I go to any website now, for example, www.mynetworktraining.com, you will see directly you will be redirected. Then this is what is called the captive portal. Okay, so this is the page that it's provided from the MyCritic router to allow the users to be authenticated in order to be able to go to the internet. And if you want, I can just show you now that if I open the command prompt here and I'll say ping, for example, 8.8.8.8. Okay, so that is the DNS server of Google, and here I'm not able to ping the DNS server of Google. But if I now log into the hotspot and I have a username and password, I already created that on the MyCritic router. So the username and password is Maher and password 123456. That's something I have already created on the MyCritic router. And when I click on OK, it will be authenticated. And please keep an eye on the ping and see what will happen. So I will say OK. And then directly I'm authenticated, and you can see I'm connected to the internet. You can see now the ping is working, and also I could go to my website and I could do whatever I want on the internet. Okay, now this is just a brief idea of what happens in the background when you are trying to connect to the hotspot. So again, the hotspot needs to be connected to the internet, and it will provide IP addresses to us via DHCP. And then when we try to connect to this SSID, which is provided by the hotspot, then we are connected to the wireless and we get an IP address with the DNS and the subnet mask and the gateway. But we are not able to connect to the internet. In order to get connected to the internet, we will be redirected to a captive portal page, which I just showed it to you. And then you need to enter your account, which is username and password, on this captive portal. And if it's authenticated, then you are directly connected to the internet and you are able to use the internet. Now, there are more details to show here, like if I want to assign for an account, the speed that I want to assign it, and how much the duration it will be connected to the internet, and so forth. There are a lot of things we can do, and that's something we would check them all on this course. But for now, I'm just showing you the whole idea of the MyCritic hotspot and why we need it. So now you know that in your company, or if you are a network engineer, you would like to deploy this for a restaurant or a cafe or any company that requires for you to have the hotspot, you have the knowledge now and you understand what is the hotspot and how to use it. So this is what I wanted to show in this lecture. I hope that you enjoyed it, and I will see you in the upcoming lecture.